Coming up on today's Out of This World Cool Stuff Collective, Eamon Holmes takes to the skies in our Big Chopper Challenge. The Cool Stuff Committee will be reviewing some of the latest book releases, and we'll be asking Monkey what's in the box in Gadget of the Week.
Hello! Welcome to the Cool Stuff Collective! I am Si Thomas, and this is Cool HQ, the coolest place on the planet! So cool, in fact, that our meat-loving DJ, Lady Blah Blah, stood still for a minute and froze. Ooh, better make sure you defrost those burgers. Don't want to get a dicky tummy. All right there, geeky Ian. What's that you got there?
Oh, yeah, that's Monkey's telescope he got for his birthday.
That is awesome. Have you seen anything cool through it yet?
I have. Take a look at that.
Oh, let's have a look. Ian, that's not cool. That's horrid. You're meant to be looking at stars.
They are stars. They're just in the shower.
Look, Ian, stargazing is not looking at celebrities having a wash. The only showers you should be seeing are meteor showers. Right, I'm going to have a look for something now, OK? Now, what you should be looking for, Ian, are real stars that illuminate everybody with their brightness. And I've just found a collection that are truly out of this world.
What is it?
It's the Cool Stuff Committee. Oh, check it out, some of the latest book releases. Enjoy.
Hi, I'm Tom and I'm 9. I've been reading Grey Wolves. In Grey Wolves, 6 boys and 1 leader have to shoot the German U-boats because it's stopping supplies getting to England. My best part in Grey Wolves is when they have to escape from occupied France. I like the book because the action never stopped. Chapter after chapter, I felt guilty if I put it down. I will give this book 4 out of 5 because I loved it.
Hi, I'm Millie and I'm 9 years old. And I've been reading Rose and the Silver Ghost.
Rose was an orphan, or so she thought, until one day she found a mirror. In that mirror there was a ghost. Ooh! And the ghost led her to her past.
I was excited to get this bit because I read the back and I was really intrigued. The best bit in the book was where Rose and her mother were reunited. It was my best bit because it was just so happy and I nearly cried. I'm going to give it a 5 out of 5 and I really want to read it again.
Hi, I'm Nicholas, and I'm 10, and I've been reading That's So Gross Animals. This book is full with gross facts. When monkeys get mad, they throw their poo at each other. Ugh! I don't know what my best bit was, because there's so many interesting facts, but one of them that really stood out for me was cows poo 16 times a day. I would have preferred this book if it was a story with all the facts packed in it, but it's not, so I'm giving it a 4 out of 5.
Oh, hi there! Monkey and I have left Cool HQ and hit the road in his car for this week's movie review.
That's right, Si. The reason I've come out in my car is because today I want to tell you about a film that's coming out soon in July, Cars 2!
Yeah, of course. That's the 3D sequel to the original movie, released in 2006, and follows Lightning McQueen and his tow truck chum Mater on their world tour as they compete in the Grand Prix to find the fastest car in the universe.
Yes, let's take a look at the trailer for the movie.
Cool. I'll keep your eye on the road.
Next summer, they're not only racing across the world, they're racing to save the world.
Finn Mac Missile, British intelligence.
So mighty. Average intelligence.
Welcome to Tokyo International Airport.
Listen, this isn't Radiator Springs.
These Americans are clearly master spies.
Oh, you've got to be joking.
Go, McQueen!
10-4, Mater.
I'm on approach.
Rocket knife.
There he is.
He's got your way.
Hang on.
Cars 2.
Mater?
I think we bit off more than we could chew.
I'm really excited about this movie. I loved the first one. I couldn't stop watching it. My favourite character is Lightning McQueen, and I just can't wait to see more of him. Oh, I love Cars so much, as you can see.
Yeah, well, thanks for taking me out for a drive in your car, Monkey, but we should probably be heading back to Cool HQ to carry on with the show now. Oi! You said you wouldn't zoom out! It's ruined the whole thing! I can afford a real car! welcome to Cool News! First up, music news now, as N-Dubs team up with the clever folk behind Little Big Planet to create the video for their single, Took It All Away. Longtime fans of the game and PlayStation console, the band jumped at the chance to create a world's first between gaming and music. Cool News! New Moon spotted from Cool HQ. Wow, that's even bigger than Uranus. Cool News! Great news for any Zen masters out there as LEGO releases its Ninja Go range. Collect all the ninjas and battle the skeleton army using the ancient art of spin jutsu. Wax on, wax off. Cool News! There are only two things I fear in life, clowns and balloons. Make it go away! Cool News! Wow, some great news stories there, as always. But as a keen astrologer myself, I spent all week making this model of the solar system made out of fruit. Anyway, see you next time for more Cool News! Next, it's time to catch up with the Cool Stuff Committee, who are testing out some of the latest book releases.
Hi, I'm Kate and I'm 10 years old. I've been reading Pip and the Woodwitch Curse. A small boy escapes from his orphanage and goes to Hangman's Hollow. The baddies try to capture all the children. It's Pip and his friend's mission to try and find the missing children and free them again. I'm going to give this book a 4 out of 5 because it was really confusing but really interesting at the same time.
Hi, I'm Jack and I'm 10. I've been reading The Amulet of Samarkand. A young magician wants revenge on his master, but at the same time, he has to stop Simon Lovelace from releasing a greater threat into the world. I enjoyed the book because there was lots of action that was building up to a big climax at the end. And I was very excited when I got this book. But I did expect it to be magical and normal at the same time. I'd give this book a 4 out of 5.
Hi, I'm Zoe, and I'm 10 years old, and I've been reading Lily Alone. When Lily's mum goes off on holiday with her new boyfriend, Lily has to look after her two younger sisters and her one younger brother all by herself, even though she's only 11. What will happen next? I've read other Jacqueline Wilson books, so I was really excited to read this one as well. I'd give this book a 4 out of 5 marks because loads of my questions weren't answered at the end.
Monkey, have you spotted anything cool from your telescope yet? Any constellations or anything?
Look, monkey see Milky Way.
Really? That's amazing. Let's have a look. Hang on a minute. That's just Cave Girl using some scales to measure how much milk is left in her bottles.
Milky Way?
No, it's a different kind of Milky Way, Monkey. Take that back. Okay. Anyway, we may not be able to find anything cool with your telescope, but I've got some very cool things here with the latest e-readers. Check these bad boys out. Now, first up, I've got this, the ViewQuest book box. Now, this little beauty has got a 5-inch extra bright screen, and now not only can it store up to 4,000 books, you can also read magazines, manuals, newspapers, and even catalogues. And of course, if you flick through a catalogue, you might see one of these! This bad boy here. This is the Arcos 70B e-reader. Very cool. This works on the Android user interface. Now, as you can see, it's got a huge 7-inch full-colour screen. That, you like this, Monkey, not only allows you to read books, but also look at images and watch videos. Wow. It's going to make me watch this show. That's cool, isn't it?
Very cool.
Now, finally, the last snazzy little e-reader I've got is this beauty. Now, this is the all-new Kindle, which has got an improved contrast, which gives it a crisper image and makes it easier to read. Now, also, you'll like this very much, Monkey, it's almost 21% smaller than the previous Kindle, meaning it's lighter and more portable, but still, it's got a whopping 6-inch screen. How cool were they?
Very cool.
Very cool indeed. I think maybe what we need to do, though, Monkey, is download a book about stargazing, because all you've seen so far for your telescope is a prehistoric lady measuring dairy products. Pointless!
True.
Monkey, this is amazing! We finally found something using your telescope! A new planet! We're going to go down in history, Monkey. We'll call it Planet Cyan Monkey from the Cool Stuff System or something. Brilliant! All right there, Ian, this is amazing. Monkey and I have found a new planet.
Just a bit of dirt on the lens, you idiots.
Oh, yeah, we knew that, didn't we, Monkey?
Yeah.
Anyway, at least now you're here, it must mean it's time for... Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Cool HQ's very own techspert, it's Ian! Yes! High fives! High fives! fives. Ian, welcome to the show. How are you?
I'm good, thanks.
Great. So what are you going to be showing us today?
We're going to talk about solar flares today.
Solar flares? Are they the trousers people used to wear in the 70s?
You shouldn't be giving fashion advice.
That's correct. Just look at my clothing. Shouldn't be doing that. OK, so what are solar flares, Ian?
Now, solar flare is activity on the surface of the sun that is pushing energy out away from the sun, not just the light and the heat that we normally feel when we're on this planet.
OK, so what do solar flares look like?
Well, the guys at NASA have sent us this footage.
Of course they have. We're a close personal showbiz friends with NASA, aren't we?
And if you look there, you can see this is specially enhanced film. And down at the bottom left there, you can see a solar flare forming.
Oh,
you can see a little burst of energy coming out of the surface of the sun. It's constantly in tension and constantly bounding around.
But why is this interesting to us on the Cool Stuff Collective?
Well, solar flares and the activity on the sun, scientists don't fully understand how and when these things happen.
Okay.
They know that we're in an 11-year cycle where the sun suddenly gets more active and there's more flares. Now, some of these flares seem to form into what they call CMEs, which are coronal mass ejections.
Okay, well said there.
And that is a big ball of energy that shoots out of the sun and off into space. You think space is empty, but there's constant waves of energy floating around. Now, to us at Cool HQ, we love our gadgets.
We do love our gadgets, indeed.
And our gadgets are powered by electricity.
Yes.
And if you imagine these iron filings here are the electricity flowing through some electronic circuit boards in our gadgets, and a massive CME comes flying through from the sun and goes through our gadgets like a giant magnet picking up these iron filings.
Oh, no!
And it has the effect of breaking the circuit.
So solar flares could do that to our gadgets and stuff, to our consoles and everything?
They could.
Oh, no.
But if we reset it like this...
Yes.
So we've got our electricity flowing through there. Monkey's had a great idea about shielding it.
He likes his shields.
A CME won't be stopped by a piece of wood and some tin foil.
It looks very high tech though, Ian. That's not bad.
But it can show the principle here. If the CME flows through there, you'll see under there the iron filings are exactly the same as we left them.
Brilliant. So that's something that we can do? Can we all become sort of like budding scientists and help protect the world using this?
We can help the scientists. There's a Solar Storm Watch website that the scientists have set up. And it means that any of us can go and look at some of the footage like we saw there to help spot unusual things happening with the sun, which gives the scientists a clue of what to look at next, because there's more solar flares than there are scientists. So if we can all help and crowdsource.
So we can all become sort of digital saviours of the world together.
Right. That's
well, that is fantastic. Well, Ian, thank you so much. Once again, you've lit off a little solar flare in my brain. Give it up one more time for Ian! Yeah. Woo! Right, so far, Monkey's seen nothing of any use through this telescope, so whilst he's off having a banana brunch, I'm going to have a sneaky peek through it, here we go. Oh, it's a bit dark, which is quite tricky to see anything. Doesn't seem to be working properly at all. Oh well, never mind, we don't need to look through a telescope to see stars in the sky, because it's now time to see which superstar celebrity is taking the controls in the Big Chopper Challenge!
This week, Eamon Holmes is taking to the skies with the quadricopter.
Hello there, I'm Eamon Holmes, and I'm ready to take on the Big Chopper Challenge.
We have liftoff.
He's off! Oi! That's cheating! I saw that, Eamon! He's stuck in the jaws of death!
It's stuck!
Wrong way, Eamon! You need to do a U-turn! Steady, Eamon! Oh, he's not even trying!
It couldn't have anything to do with me!
Steady, Eamon! Nearly there! Amazing control! Or it would be if he wasn't holding it.
Yeah!
Well, I don't know exactly what time it on the clock there, but it must be good. It must be really, really good. Beat that. I mean, that was flying. And, a wee bit of... Well, it's called assistance, really. Some people may say it's cheating, but I prefer to call it... assistance.
An unorthodox fly pass there from Eamon Holmes. Look like cheating to me. But how did he do? Let's check out the Cool Stuff leaderboard. Amy completed his flight in an incredible 4 minutes and 51 seconds, which puts him into second place behind speedy skater Laura Hamilton. Anyway, I'm going to try and have another look through Monkey's telescope now. Here we go. No, no, do you know, I still can't see anything. Is it even turned on? Oi, Monkey, is this thing broken? What are you laughing at?
Hello, Si. Yes, as you know, I've been working tirelessly round the clock, trying to come up with some groundbreaking inventions that I think might just change the world. Now, I really, really like to eat soup. I also like to watch TV. And I thought, what if I could combine the two and create a remote control spoon so that I can eat my soup and watch TV together? All I need for this is one spoon, and also one TV remote, indeed. So I place spoon onto the remote like so, and a little bit of the sticky stuff, special sticky stuff. Ah, here we go. I have to stick it like so there. Perfect. Let's see if it works, shall we? So I take this and I dip it into my... And I think I'll try and change the remote. Right, changing it. I guess, back to the drawing board.
Now, last time we had Professor Stuff on the show, we had so many complaints that the TV authorities have insisted that we balance things up by showing 5 seconds of a gnome doing Irish dancing. Okay, now we're even. Right, Monkey, we still haven't seen anything good through your stupid telescope.
Oh, Monkey, see Big Dipper?
What? You can see the star constellation, the Big Dipper, finally! Oh, no, it's just Lady Blah Blah dipping a whole chicken into a bucket of ketchup. It's a different type of Big Dipper. Anyway, moving swiftly on, it's now time for... Yes, welcome to Si Size It Up, my very own little part of the show where I, yes, I, get to wax lyrical to you about what's really cool in the world of gaming. And oh, have I got a cool one for you today. Yes, Test Drive Unlimited 2, the latest in high-speed racing games, available now on the PS3, Xbox 360 and PC. Now, I'm a very big fan of racing games as I love the high-speed driving feeling. Yeah. And I also love it when racing games have great graphics and make the driving experience oh so realistic, and that's exactly what Test Drive Unlimited 2 does. This game puts you at the controls of some of the world's most desirable cars and allows you to drive them in loads of different locations and under loads of different driving conditions. Yep, you can race in rain, shine, night or day. But enough banging on about it. It's time to get behind the wheel, and to do that, I've enlisted the world's greatest driver. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Monkey Schumacher. There he is. All right, Monkey, get ready. Here goes. Right, we are on the starting grid. And there he goes! He's off! There you go, Monkey. Looking good. Now, obviously, Monkey is playing the single-player career mode version of this game, which is very, very cool. You sort of roam around trying to find races. And when you win those races, you win money, which you can then spend on new cars, clothing, or even on a new home, so you can really live the racing driver lifestyle. You enjoy that, Monkey? You want to be a racing driver, don't you? Now, what makes this game really, really extra cool is that you can play online against your friends around the world. It's got massively open online racing that allows you to not only compete with up to 8 players, but also drive alongside them in co-op mode. I think you could do with some help, couldn't you, Monkey? I think what Monkey needs is a pit stop. Cave Girl, get in here. Cave Girl, come on. That's it. Walk him down. Give him a little drink. He's liking that, isn't he? He's enjoying that. Okay, Monkey, you ready? You're back. Okay, here goes. Do better. Now, also, you can drive some super cool, super realistic supercars, such as the Ferrari Enzo, the McLaren MP4 12C, and the Lotus Evora, and loads more. And what type of car have you got, Monkey?
What?
Oh, anyway. Anyway, this game is fantastic. Please do go check it out. It's out now on PC, PS3, and Xbox. I think you're really going to like it. See what I did there? Wheel. Oh, forget it. Next week on Star Sets It Up, very excitedly, I will be bringing you the all-new Nintendo 3DS! So make sure you tune in for that. It's now time for probably the most exciting part of the show, when Monkey opens his box to show us his gadget of the week. And for this, I brought a touch of glamour to the proceedings with this snazzy gold jacket. Yeah. Such a Hollywood. Now, Monkey, it's time to ask you, what's in the box? Monkey, that is really cool. What is it?
This sign is the Dell Streak. It's a pocket-sized tablet that's also a mobile phone. It's got this 5-inch screen so you can watch movies and play games and listen to music and use the internet whilst making calls. And it has a 5-megapixel camera built in the front so you can make video calls.
Wow, Monkey, that's incredible. I need one of those. Could I have it?
No, monkeys.
He is so stroppy. Ah, well, sadly, that's all we've got time for on this week's incredibly cool and fun-packed Cool Stuff Collective. But join us again next week where we'll have more cool gadgets, more cool toys, more cool movies, more cool, well, everything. And don't forget, you can get in touch with us here at the Cool Stuff Collective by going to itv.com/CITV and clicking on the Cool Stuff Collective. We would love to hear from you, so please do get in touch. Remember, itv.com/CITV. We shall see you next week. But in the meantime, Monkey, do you know what? We've seen nothing good through this telescope at all. You've got one last chance. Come on.
Monkey can see Great Bear.
What? You can see the star constellation, the Great Bear?
No, it's a great big bear. It's heading straight.
Oh, it's got a fish! Run! Run, it's a bear! It's a bear! Why is the gnome back here? What are you? Oh, just get away from me. It's got a fish. I hate fish. Why are you still got fish? Help! Get in touch with us. ITV.com/CITV.
The Cool Stuff Collective, in association with Nerf and Strike.